Why do VQs sound trash? Now, before everyone gets triggered, I just want to say that I do own this Nissan 350Z right here, and it sounds absolutely amazing. I'm not here to diss VQs, as they can sound fucking awesome, but I am here to discuss why most VQs out on the road sound like a tin can. So let's get right into it. Now, first of all, VQs do have a very distinctive sound, and in the car community, it is typically regarded as a trumpet or a raging elephant. And this is true, regardless if you have a $50 exhaust or a $3,000 exhaust, you're still gonna have that distinctive VQ sound. But why do so many sound like this? And not like this? And the simple answer obviously comes down to the exhaust, but it's a bit deeper than that. Now, the G35 and the 350Z obviously share the same engine. However, they also share amazing performance out of the box for a very affordable price. Now, a lot of people are getting into these cars because they don't have 30K to drop on a JDM shitbox. And what comes with that is often car enthusiasts that own these cars don't have thousands of dollars to drop on aftermarket parts, or they just have their priorities straight. For example, Jimmy over here doesn't have a spare $3,000 to drop on a titanium racing exhaust, so he settles for some random cheap exhaust on eBay, and it works fine, but it probably sounds like this. Now, reason number two is that I just think people are sick of hearing VQs all the time. Now, VQ cars were mass produced, and that is pretty much the only reason why the 350Z is still so affordable. They just made so goddamn many of them. So there is a lot of people that have just entered the car scene with minimal funds, and there are a lot of awesome VQ cars out there for affordable prices. When you put those two together, you're bound to get some horrible sounding exhausts. Now, number three is something that I just quite can't crack. Now, I bought this car bone stock. So I bought it with 11,000 miles a few years ago, and I was in high school. I didn't know if I was going to do an exhaust to it or not. And about a month or so after ownership, I decided, okay, we're going to do something. What's cheap? What can I do? And the first thing that I ever did to the car was a muffler delete. Yes, I know, a muffler delete, the world-renowned hated thing, but I was actually surprised it didn't actually sound that bad. Like, maybe I liked it more because I was in high school and, like, my tolerance for bad noises was a bit better then. I don't know, but it actually didn't even sound that bad. I was pretty impressed, so that only cost me, like, a few hundred dollars for some random shop to do it. I didn't have to do anything myself, just dropped it in, got it same day, super easy, and it sounded all right. But then eventually, after that as well, a couple months later, I was like, okay, it needs to be louder. So what did your boy decide to do? He got Burke test pipes. Yes, he decided to get non-resonated Burke test pipes to see how that would sound. And it did sound similar to the muffler delete sound, but just a million decibels louder. The test pipes just freed up that exhaust and made it ridiculously loud. It was pretty insane, to be honest. And then eventually, I knew that I always wanted something else other than just the muffler delete, and a deal on a Tome exhaust came up. And I was like, I have to get that one 100%. So it was on Facebook Marketplace. It said posted 1 minute ago, and I picked that bad boy up for like, what, $800-$900 Australian, which was a pretty fucking good bargain if you do ask me. So now the current setup on the vehicle is obviously the Burke test pipes with the Tome exhaust. Now, I do have a Tome exhaust compilation right here. You can just click on that video, and that is probably the best slept on compilation of 350Zs you've ever heard. So if you love the sound of VQs, click on that video. Also be linking it in the description down below. But yeah, basically number three was why I can't crack is why VQs sound like shit all the time, when like I had a muffler delete and I thought it actually sounded pretty good. Like, yeah, it didn't sound like crazy or amazing or anything, but it sounded pretty solid. All the ones I see on the internet and on the YouTube and even in real life sound fucking horrible. I don't understand why. I don't know what exhausts people do be putting on these 350Zs. It just baffles me. I have no idea what's going on. But yeah, let me know what you think of my Le Mans Sunset Orange 350Z. I am slacking at the moment. It is actually really dirty. Might go and wash it today. Let me know what you think of the car. Let me know what you think of the exhaust. Go watch that video and let me know what you think. Thank you so much for tuning in. And if you haven't subscribed to me already and you've watched this video all the way to this point, I mean, come on. Come on, he just hit the subscribe. I need to get to 1,000. We can get the channel monetized. We'll start gaining some serious momentum when we hit that 1,000. So please hit that subscribe. I'm kind of begging and it's pretty sad, but yeah, it would be really nice. We're at like 710, 711 or something. So that'd be really, really sick. I thank you so much for watching today's video. Like I said, a million times. Yeah, peace out, boys.